The regular season finale is underway.
Tulsa starts man-to-man. Probably play a little more zone today than they've played in the past. Bulldogs are looking. Normally they look to get it into Eli down low. This time they gave it to him up high.
It's Eli. Turns, fires, and hits as he knocks Shelton to the floor.
Well, Shelton flopped. I know there's been a lot of concern on the Bulldogs' part that that's the way people are guarding Melvin Eli. Throw the chest into him and then flop when you feel any contact.
Harrington with a runner.
Harrington's very tough. They'll run all their sets. They'll run a lot of screens. But if Harrington has an opening, he'll take it himself, as he did there.
2-2. First minute of play from Celand Arena. Maddox works off the screen. Eli had a hard time getting open inside. 10 on the shot clock. Now Eli one-on-one. Foul on Shelton.
I wouldn't be surprised to see them switch that matchup and put Johnson on Shelton. If you remember, Ralph, down in Tulsa, when Shelton didn't start, Eli just controlled the game from the outset. They're trying Shelton because he's the best defender they have, but they certainly don't want to get him in foul trouble.
He's up near 70% from the line this year. That's an incredible turnaround. Were you surprised to see him out there for senior ceremonies tonight?
No, I know his mother flew in for the game, and I know he just, you know, Laura Pocket from the women's team, I think, had three senior nights. So maybe it's the thing to do.
2-2 game. Swanson. Shelton picked up by Porter. That's a mismatch. Swanson a drive. Blocked by Eli. 27 straight games for the Fresno State all-time leader. And a turnover at the other end.
Yeah, Swanson never gave up on it. Jeffries didn't realize he was behind him.
Johnson inside, puts it up and in over Swillis.
Yeah, he had good position on Swillis coming back in transition. Got the ball in deep.
Tulsa with four unanswered points, leads it 4-2. Jeffries for three, and the Bulldogs are back in front.
Penetrate and score for Tulsa, penetrate and pitch for Fresno State.
Inside, Shelton gets away from Swillis, throws the layup, then has it knocked away by Swillis. And Swillis is saying to somebody, we should have switched.
Well, what happened there? No, Ralph, the Bulldogs, in their effort to deny the pass up top, you saw the tail end of it, they are trying to deny the ball to Tulsa's big men. That will leave them open to back doors, and that's what Shelton did right there. He just didn't complete it. You can see the pressure here.
Harrington will fire for three. Rebound taken by Johnson. Off glass and in.
And Bulldogs were lucky several times. They switched and they didn't want to switch on that. Left Harrington up and you don't want to give him a three, nor do you want to give Shelton the backdoor layup.
Jeffries to Porter for three. Rebound to Shelton. 6-5. Tulsa leads. 17-10 to play in the first half.
That's what they're talking about. They're trying to deny that pass.
Harrington throws it out of bounds. It'll be Bulldog ball.
Swillis got in the passing lane. Shelton wasn't sure if he was going to backdoor him or jab him and come out. Harrington couldn't wait, threw it out of bounds. That's a forced turnover.
Jeffries looking inside to Eli. Gets it to Eli. He's double teamed. Porter again for three. That's no good. He gets the rebound. Takes it back up. Harrington driving on Maddox. Picked up foul. Tito Maddox to pick up his first.
Harrington's very difficult to guard in the open floor. We talked about before, they run sets, they set screens, but if he sees an opening, he'll take it. When he comes down the floor, he has a head of steam here. You're on your own. There's not too much help, and he knows it. He's going to try to take you one-on-one.
Dante Swanson out of the game for Tulsa, replaced by Antonio Reed, number three. That was Marcus Hill with the shot. The other end, Jeffries with a stutter step. This is the front. Jeffries, triple team, gets it to Eli. Bulldogs off to a cold start shooting the basketball.
Getting some good looks, but they're not going down. Jeffries' play would have been sensational if he could have gotten it.
Off on Reed, right hand.
Porter did an outstanding job of getting over the screen set by Johnson and then getting it to Reed. Reed pushed off.
Antonio Reed picks up his first personal. Two team fouls on Tulsa. One for the Bulldogs as Jason Parker checks in for Tulsa. Marcus Hill goes to the bench.
This is a three-guard lineup they have now. You got Reed, Parker, and Harrington, three little guys in there. Tough match for Chris Jeffries.
Swartz, he'll drive. Shannon Swartz.
Some people may say, I don't think Buzz Peterson's too happy about something. I'm not sure what it is.
Peterson came out on the court to complain about something. I believe it was Melvin Eli did, because the official was talking to Eli.
On the floor.
We'll sort it out during the timeout. 15:48 to play. Fresno State leading the Golden Hurricane 7-6. Shannon Swartz with the Dogs on top.
Fox 26 is brought to you by Gottschalks. Discover the world of Gottschalks.
We'll have time to be part of March Madness and watch the Dogs defend their WAC tournament title in Tulsa. The official 2001 WAC tournament travel package includes air travel, hotel, ground transportation, and game tickets. For information, call the Athletic Business Office at 278-4033. 15:48 to play at Sound Arena. Fresno State leading 7-6 in what has been a seesaw battle. The discussion during the timeout was about Melvin Eli throwing a little elbow.
Well, I think he and Johnson got tangled up, and, you know, the coach always been citing his players' behalf. You can see the Bulldogs really pushing Tulsa away from the basket. This is what they want to do.
Johnson blocked by Eli, his second of the game.
So Johnson tried to create contact. Now, if Eli flopped there, he could have gotten a foul on him. You see here, watch Johnson lean right into him. See, that's supposed to be an offensive foul. Eli holds his ground instead of going down. If he goes down, I think he gets the call.
80th block of the season for Eli. Harrington kicks it out. Shelton for three. Rebound and a foul. Going to be going over the back, Kevin Johnson.
Yeah, that's really tough. When you penetrate and pitch, it's a tough play because we've talked about today's game is penetrate and pitch. But when you penetrate and pitch to your power forward and he can shoot a three, that makes it all the more difficult. Willis did a pretty good job of getting a hand on him.
He does shoot a lot of three-pointers over there, Shelton. He's 35-93 on the year, 38%. This is one of the top three-pointing. Three-point shooting team in the country.
Right, and the top three-point shooting team percentage-wise in the WAC.
8 on the shot clock. And trying to create. Looking for an opening. Great play by Tito Maddox with the shot clock winding down.
Yeah, nice footwork. Knowledge of the clock.
Harrington driving the other end. Works his way open. Can't finish. And rebound nice. Comes off to Eli.
And nice footwork there, too.
Swartz kicks it out to Porter, looking for his first points of the game. And gets him on a three.
Now that's where you get your threes. Tulsa's the leading three-point field goal shooting percentage team. The Bulldogs are the leaders in threes made. And you can see Shannon Swill is trying to deny. And the Bulldogs will switch their big guys and trap the screen.
Parker thought about the shot to the corner, but gives it up. Johnson inside. Off the back of the iron. Gets his own rebound. Loses it on the way up. It goes to Jeffries. Jeffries. Three. In and out.
We talked about it before. The Bulldogs are long inside. You got three guys with 7-foot wingspans, including Chris Jeffries. The ball goes inside. It's not an automatic two for anybody.
Harrington trying to call out a play from the coach. He looks like he doesn't know what it is.
And there's the trap on the pick and roll and the rotation.
Johnson fouled by Porter. Thursday night in the clincher, I don't think Jerry Tarkanian was happy with the intensity of the man-to-man defense. He can't be disappointed tonight.
No, the Bulldogs are playing the way they want to play. They want to try to, they're going to switch post to post, and they're going to switch on the perimeter 1, 2, and 3.
Eli and Porter go out coming into the game for Fresno State. Travis Demandy and, surprisingly, Mustafa El-Sayed was not expected to play after injuring his ankle, 6 days ago against Nevada.
Right, and it was a bad injury. Ed Ferreira said he's never seen anyone as tough as Mustafa, nor has he ever seen anyone come back as quickly from that type of injury.
Reed pulls up over to Mandy and hits. Four-point Bulldog lead, just under 13 minutes to play in the half. And make it six. It's his second basket of the night.
Well, we see a lot of similarities. Each team likes to penetrate and pitch. Each team likes to penetrate and score. And each team likes to set the screen out top. There you saw a switch between the Mamby and Maddox.
Parker takes it inside the three-point line. Gets Swillis up in the air and draws the foul.
And John Welch, who scouts Tulsa, one of the things he talked about is the Golden Hurricane players like to get you up with a head fake. Here it comes, head fake, gets you up in the air, draw the contact, shoot the free throws, and they're one of the better free throw shooting teams in the league.
Parker had to wait a while for Swillis to come down. Parker is 77% free throw shooter. Misses the first as Shelton goes out. He's replaced by Jack Ingram, a 6'10" freshman who averages 3 points and 3 rebounds a game.
I think they're getting him in. He had a tough time with Melvin Eli in the first contest. I think with Melvin out of the game, they feel like he playing against Mustafa El-Sayed and other freshmen is a better matchup for him.
5-point Bulldog lead, under 12 and a half minutes to play in the first half.
Bulldogs are in their driving game.
Demandy wide open for three. And a foul underneath on the rebound. Going to be on Tulsa, so the Bulldogs will keep the ball. And again, Buzz Peterson out on the floor, arguing with the official.
And right there, Ralph, what you see is Mustafa El-Sayed, while not being as talented a player as Melvin Eli, works harder for offensive rebounds. He went there, Ingram grabbed his shirt. That's what Ruben Ramos, the official, said to Peterson. He said, "How can you call a foul on our guy?" And he said, "He was grabbing his shirt. I had to."
Jeffries double, triple teamed and tied up. Jump ball. Tulsa will have it. Noel Felix is into the game for Fresno State, replacing Shannon Swillis.
Yeah, on that play, Jeffries has a quick first step, beats his man, but the help, there were too many guys down low, too congested.
Parker gets it inside, intended for Hill off of his hand, and out of bounds, so they give it right back. The Bulldogs will have it. When we come back, 11:57 to play in the first half from Selland Arena. Chris Jeffries and the Bulldogs lead it by 5. George Mason with the weather on the KMPH 10 o'clock news. The Valley's only primetime newscast, only on your station, KMPH, Fox 26. Been a long time since they've been able to hang one of those in Selland Arena, Jack. 1982.
Never hung one of those.
That's right.
Conference champion, but not black, right? Actually, Ralph, I think it was 3 years ago, co-champions of the West Division or, you know, whatever, when they had the 16 teams, all you could do was win your division. I think it was tied with Hawaii for a championship that year.
14-9, Bulldogs lead.
And Tulsa coming out in their matchup zone.
Lob from Demandy, too tall for Chris Jeffries. So the team's exchanging turnovers.
It actually looked like a pretty good pass. I don't think Chris might have timed it right. I know that Tulsa went to get it, couldn't. Only the second turnovers for the Bulldogs.
Well, just because you could have reached it doesn't mean Jeffries could have got it.
Yeah, with a long stick.
Hill misses. The rebound comes off Charlie Davis.
Right, they shoot a lot of threes, and when you do shoot threes, and there's your three man blocking a shot.
Jeffries with the
threes,
block.
You have long rebounds.
Maddox pulls up and hits.
It's a two-point shot.
Sometimes you don't have any rebounds.
Fresno State's biggest lead, 7 points. Another turnover. Maddox has Demandy. Bounce pass to Travis. Lays it up. Lays it off. Offensive foul on Demandy. No basket. Now, this one, I'm not sure that this is the worst call of the year. We'll take a look at it here. You can see right there. You have to be set. Maybe. I don't know. This might be a better look. You have to give a guy a chance who goes up to come down. It's not the worst call of the year, but I think it might be in the finals. Bulldogs are really scrambling out front. So Noel Felix guarding the guard.
Eli back in now. He's guarding Davis.
Okay, got away with a quick push.
Knocked out of bounds with 13 on the shot clock. Substitution for Tulsa. Harrington and Swanson back in for Reed and Parker. And the Boos cascading down. Fans still don't like that offensive foul called on Travis Demandy. Jerry Tarkanian now trying to match Buzz Peterson, giving the official an earful at this end of the floor. Harrington, nothing but net.
Now, Demetrius Porter tried to go over the top of the screen. If you do that on a shooter, he's going to fade to the corner. Demetrius should know that because he's a shooter. Damon Jackson's in the game now. He's had some good practices. Right on cue. He can knock it down. He's leading scorer in the CBC last year for Sequoias.
Hill at the other end. Rebound comes off to Demandy.
Has Jackson.
Jackson loses it on the way up.
That's a play made famous by Terrence Roberson.
Gets open again at the other side. Fires for three. Rebound goes to Demandy. Porter fouled on the drive. No basket, foul before the shot.
That's not the last one of those you're going to see. Each of these teams drives a lot. And the emphasis this year is the caller's hand checks. So, especially on an inside-out pass. Demanding made a wise move. He was near the basket, but probably would have gotten a shot blocked, so he kicked it out. Caused the closeout. Demetrius, quick first step, caused the foul.
Shelton back in for Tulsa as Davis goes to the bench. 19-11, 8-point lead for Fresno State. Eli being pushed by Ingram. Demandy for three. Fresno State getting open shots. Not going down yet.
No, I can't believe Tulsa's happy with the shots Fresno State's getting.
Harrington turns it over. Willis gives it up. Porter still can't get it to go. Foul underneath on Fresno State.
Things close a second. Well, on the last exchange down at the Tulsa offensive end, they ran a two-man game. Just didn't realize there was a third man from Fresno State in there. Shannon Swillis goes over and rotates over, realizing that the screen and roll, the roll man's not going to be played. That's how he got the steal.
Maddox back in for the Bulldogs, replacing Demandy. Kevin Johnson returns for Tulsa.
Now, this is very dangerous, the way that Tulsa's giving Fresno State's three-point shooters open looks. Dangerous for Tulsa.
Swanson. Swanson again. In and out. Rebound, Damon Jackson.
Fresno State's doing a real nice job of guarding and rotating.
Maddox picking his way around the screens, gives it up to Porter. Eli backing in on Johnson. Del Team puts it up.
That's why they consider him player of the year.
10-point Bulldog lead, the biggest of the game.
You can see this is pressure defense right here. There's rotation.
Knock away by Swillis.
Rotation by Swillis.
Bulldogs on the break. Porter spins it up. Can't get it. Kicks it. Tulsa.
And the record's been said that Swillis and Porter, you can't find one without the other. So I guess when Porter threw that up, he figured Swillis was going to be close by.
12-point Bulldog lead. Fresno State turning it on behind Melvin Eli. Exciting technical innovations put you in the driver's seat. Coverage of the Las Vegas 400 begins Sunday morning at 11:30. Watch it exclusively on KMPH, Fox 26. Back at Sullivan Arena, 12-point Fresno State lead, 23-11 Bulldogs with 7:57 to play in the first half. Ralph Wood and Jack Furtick, along with more than 10,000 Bulldog fans.
And this is an improvised press by Shannon Swillis. Jerry Tarkanian didn't call this, but they forced Swanson to bring it up the floor instead of Hearn.
Johnson working on Eli. Shelton with the rebound. A whistle and a turnover. Struggled to lost his balance with the basketball, so Fresno State will get it back.
And that was the same official that called the charge at the other end. Shelton lost his balance. I think he might have lost it. I think he might have had help losing it.
Time now for This Week in Bulldog Sports, brought to you by AT&T Wireless Services. Your baseball team back in action for a pair of team sets beginning Tuesday, taking on Eastern Michigan, and again next weekend against Miami of Ohio. The softball team opens its home season Tuesday night against Colorado State, then hosts the Hedricks Halliwell Chevrolet Softball Classic Thursday through Sunday at Bulldog Diamond. For tickets, call 278-DOGS or go online at GoBulldogs.com. This Week in Bulldog Sports, brought to you by AT&T Wireless Services.
We'd also like to wish Ralph a speedy recovery to Jamie Southern. Terrific young pitcher for the Bulldogs, and threw a couple shutouts and then just underwent surgery. Terrific. I know Jerry Tarkanian had a bad ankle and was in the training room, happened to be next to her for several days, and was so moved when he saw the newspaper article. He wrote her a note wishing her a speedy recovery. She and Mustafa Al-Sayed were in the same class, and the day the Bulldog softball team was introduced at women's basketball game, they were sitting in the same area, Moose and I were, and she invited Moose over. I guess they had a Thanksgiving dinner they had missed because one of her aunts was out of town. They were having it later, and she invited Moose over. I mean, a terrific young lady, has a great future here. Is going to get a redshirt year due to the injury. You know, you talked about Shannon Swillis trying to get his back. This is an injury year for her. You hope not, but should there be another injury to her where she would lose a year, that's what would cause a sixth year. Shannon Swillis going to have a tough time because he lost a year to injury at SC, but his other year he lost was when he transferred from SC to Fresno. That's the difference.
And he'll get his degree from USC.
Yes, that's right. He did arrange that when he transferred. Was only 12 units away from it when he first came here.
Bulldogs lead by a dozen. 7 minutes, 20 seconds to play in the half.
And Tulsa back in the zone.
Maddox. Jackson now gets to Swillis. Three on the shot clock. Porter's going to have to foul. Shelton the rebound.
And Porter's right there. He's 1-for-7 right now, and he will not stop shooting.
Swanson open at the other end. He hits a three.
Has a bad match in transition. Bulldogs didn't pick up Swanson. It wasn't that they didn't have anybody back. They just didn't have anybody matched with him.
Eli. Oh, he just makes it look easy.
You don't realize how hard a shot that is. But the tough thing is they went zone because they didn't like their matchups on Eli, but when you let him catch the ball close to the box, it doesn't matter what defense you're in.
Eli with the rebound. Fresno State by 11.
And he might be getting away with a little shove initially on that defense, too.
Porter, overdue. Finally gets the three.
No, he's not going to stop. That's Jerry Tarkanian's trademark. His shooter, the guys he gives the green light to, are going to shoot. And Demetrius Porter, there's no lack in confidence in the guys who shoot for Jerry.
Fresno State's doubled it up. leading 28-14. Swanson, who just hit their first three-point basket, 0-4 up to that point. Shelton double team, bounce pass to Harrington. He's cut off. Five on the shot clock, and Harrington fouled along the baseline.
With four on the shot clock, that's a terrific defensive possession. You got 31 seconds of great defense, and I think the feet just got tangled up. Here's the end of it. He takes them off the dribble. Yeah, and their feet got tangled up. I mean, it's a foul because the defender caused the offensive player to go down and put him at a disadvantage, and that's the rule advantage disadvantage. But it was a tough play.
Two fouls on Maddox in the terrific lob play from Harrington to Johnson.
Yeah, that was a set lob play, and you had, unfortunately for the Bulldogs, the two backup post players in there. They didn't communicate and got burned.
Lob at the other end. Jeffries looked like he was held.
Hill went underneath him. Hill undercut him. I think Lynn Short and AC, the referee, was blocked off because he was on the other side of the basket. David Stevens out front might have been blocked off too, but from the view we have, it looked like Hill rode him out.
Dogs by 12, just over 5 minutes to play in the first half.
And Tulsa right now is going to their spread game.
Harrington got hit in the nose, gives it off to Reed for the three.
They went to their spread game because they know the Bulldogs are denying. That stretches the defense, and it puts the defender on the ball one-on-one.
I think they're going to take a timeout for Harrington, who got hit in the nose at the other end.
The Manby can certainly have empathy for this.
So Harrington will leave, replaced by Jason Parker. Bulldogs will have the ball out of bounds with 28 on the shot clock. Coming up at halftime, we'll have the Bulldogs spotlight. We'll also have KMPH 10 o'clock news halftime report, the Enterprise, Rent-A-Car first half stats and highlights coming up at halftime. Tennis is in the Bulldogs spotlight tonight. Turnover. If Reed can get it, he does. Gives it up. And a transition basket as I was screened out by Tulsa. Golden Hurricane starting to blow here. Seven unanswered points. Felix in trouble.
Two careless passes
saved by Hill, but Felix tracks it down. And another careless pass by Felix. Parker has it blocked. So Felix makes one mistake, atones for it, makes another mistake, and atones for that.
Well, he's a lot better at blocking shots than he is at passing. There's the pass.
And Forget about it.
Tell me what you think. Which one's he better?
He stays in the game. He's shaking his head. Fresno State with five blocks already. At least two of those by the leader, Marvin Eli. Well, Eli has three. And now another rebound. As he gets tangled up.
I'd like
with three. That's
foul.
A 6-10 against a 5
foul is going to be on.
It's going to be on Reed, who couldn't get out of the way.
Yeah, right. Well, what happened was, and this is what we talked about before, Eli went up and grabbed the rebound. You have to let a guy come down. Normally, you would call maybe somebody over the back, but in that case, Eli was just a lot taller and had possession of the ball and then was fouled. Next foul, each team is shooting.
Eli turns to the right, fouled on the shot by Ingram.
You know, Ingram did what he wanted. He forced him off the block, and he forced him into the turnaround jump shot. It's just that once he went up, he kept bodying him. If he had stayed straight, you can see here, he pushed him. This is pretty far off the block. He just should have stayed up. He would have forced him into the shot he wanted.
Eli missed two earlier in the game. Hits the first hit.
Eli's really worked on his free throw shooting for a couple reasons. The main one being that he knew he was going to get fouled a lot.
Makes a goal. He's 2-for-4 from the line in this game. And there's a timeout. 3:56 to play in the first half. Bulldogs build the lead back up to 9. Plymouth during the final of the Hendricks Halliwell Chevrolet Softball Classic, and packed the park for four exciting softball games, including a 3 o'clock showdown between the UCLA Bruins and your Fresno State Bulldogs. All general admission single day tournament passes will be on sale at regular season prices. The tickets call 278-DOGS or go online at GoBulldogs.com. 3:56 to play in the first half at Sun Arena. It's 30-21. Fresno State leading by 9. The Bulldogs' biggest lead was 14. Eli's free throws end as a 7-0 scoring streak by Tulsa.
And look for Tulsa to run a set play out of a timeout. There it is, guard around.
Parker puts it up, then off the basket.
Come on, defense, we're right there.
7-point Bulldog lead. 3.5 to play in the first half. Knocked away by Parker and out of bounds. Bulldogs will have it with 22 on the shot clock.
And now with Tulsa that's getting into the passing lanes. Back in their zone for the remainder of the possession.
Felix gets it inside. Eli. Can't stop him. He's backed in and got great position. It's virtually a layup.
Yeah, he has trouble with some bigger guys. Stewart from UTEP for one, but there aren't too many guys bigger than he is in the league.
Jeffries playing a great defense on Hill, has to give it up.
Well, Jeffries guards the 5'10 guys when he comes in. He guards Hill.
Watson fouled from behind on the shot. Looks like it's going to be on Noel Felix.
I think they got him reaching in. Porter looked like he might have been in a good position to take a charge. But I think they got Felix first. So you can see right there. Here's Porter. He has position. But Noel Felix reached in.
First foul on Felix. 17 fouls on the side. Swanson shooting two. 4 points for Dante Swanson. Harrington checks back in.
It's only Swanson's 16th free throw attempt in 15 conference games.
Takes them both. 5 in the game for Swanson, a 7-point lead for the Bulldogs. Eli working hard inside against Charlie Davis. Maddox, rebound Hill.
Yeah, usually you don't see that. It's a shake and bake three-pointer. Pretty much sure that's what they were looking for.
Harrington with a floater and a foul. Count the basket. And a foul after the basket. Going to be on Harrington, I believe. Foul is on Harrington.
Well, this is a call a lot of people, fans and coaches alike, really don't like. It should be one way or the other. I think that's the way it is in high school. As a matter of fact, it's either a block and the basket counts, it's a charge and no basket, or it's a good basket and a no call.
So we come back to the other end where Jeffries will shoot 1-1 with 2:17 to play. And this is the front end. Kept alive and knocked out of bounds. Kept alive by Felix, knocked out of bounds by Harrington. So the Bulldogs get a break there.
Felix backs up Swillis, and he's seen Shannon Swillis do that an awful lot. Smart play. He blocked out, goes straight up, and just try to keep the ball alive.
Jeffries just powered his way through like a pulling guard.
Yeah, and Jeffries is a great passer for a guy that's 6'8". It's a nice look right there. Probably could have taken the ball to the basket.
Eli in double figures with 12. A turnover. Jeffries tracks it down. Pretty good defender, too. Fires the long three and hit.
Right there. Penetrated. Passed for an assist. Rotated over, got his hand out, got the steal, came down, hit a free transition.
5 straight points for the Bulldogs. Again, the lead is... 10 on the shot clock. Swanson forget about it. Eli with the block, but then throws it away. Still no reset on the shot clock, so he has to get this reset. It should not have been reset. No, full back basketball. Now the officials are going to discuss this.
Well, I'll tell you why it should have been a reset. The official's right. It should have been a reset because, not because the ball hit the rim, it didn't, but because Melvin Eli had possession. And as soon as he had possession, they reset. He throws the thing out. This is a good call.
We had that situation earlier in the year when the official had to come over and take a look at the tape.
You see it here, he drives in. This is a bad idea.
Blocked by Eli.
And you can see right there, he should have possession of the ball.
Now we got to go back.
That's close, though, because he doesn't even come down.
Well,
maybe one foot hits.
If they called that not possession, and Michael Jordan would have had a lot of times he didn't have possession of the ball, he dunked it.
Dark proof his case.
Now, in this one, officials are right. He does have possession. It doesn't matter if he's in the air or not.
Well, I'm sure Jerry will ask you about that in the locker room. And he can set his mind at ease.
And as long as they keep this lead at about 13, I can tell him.
The shot clock has been turned off with only 15 seconds remaining in the half.
So Tulsa gets it back. 15 seconds to play.
That was good offense and good defense, that possession. This is good basketball right here. You have two good teams, Jeff. This is why they're 1-2 in the league.
There's their straight drive. Tulsa for the fifth straight time.
And here's the spread game that they're going to. That should be a travel. That's an automatic travel.
Foul on the three-point shot.
That's right. You see this right here. You go on the floor. You cannot move. There Swanson goes on the floor, and he rolls. Automatic. It's just like jumping up and coming down. If you fall, automatic travel. This right here, you
point out where it is.
Right here, you can see Porter gets his hand in. There Swanson has the ball. He cannot move right now. And as he rolls over, that's an automatic travel. Not Swanson, I believe it's Parker.
With 2.6 seconds left, Swanson will shoot three free throws.
Right, and Swanson didn't realize how much time was on the clock. He rushed it. Travis DeMambi should not have fouled in that situation.
Maddox in for Fresno State, replacing DeMambi. Tark hoping that he could do something with it with 2.6 left.
If anybody can get it from one end to the other in 2.6, it's Tito Maddox.
And he'll have his opportunity, but they'll pick up defensive pressure in the backcourt. Great pass from Eli Maddox. Oh, that would have been a spectacular play because Melvin Eli threw a terrific shot like a quarterback in football, leading Maddox beautifully. He caught it in stride, had a great opportunity for the basket, but just couldn't get it to fall. Still, Fresno State takes a 10-point lead to the locker room at halftime. Bulldogs 40, Tulsa 30. Good first half, Fresno State.
Most of next week, both sides would like to wrap up shortly after. In downtown Fresno, Karen Garcia-Diaz, the 10 o'clock news.
The case is expected to be turned over to the jury after next week. Okay, here now with a quick check of our weather is George Mason. George?
All right, Eric. Well, the rain moving into the area tonight is just the beginning of it. It looks like it'll be about a two-day event, but the snow level will be way up there. It'll start out at about 7,000 feet this time. None of the 3,000 feet stuff we had here a couple of weeks ago. Matter of fact, it'll take a couple of days even to get down to about 5,000 feet. But that's the thing. It looks like a couple of days of rain with the heaviest of it on the Sunday afternoon. So we're in for a couple of soggy days. To be sure, we see things clearing out to partly cloudy to mostly cloudy toward the end of the week. We'll be back later, Eric.
Thanks so much, George. And that is our halftime report. As George just mentioned, we'll be back at 10 with the latest news, sports, and weather. Now, back to the game.
Hello? Hello?
Happy
birthday to me.
For the great taste that will fill you up and never let you down.
Hello. Security.
Make it a Bud Light.
I'm Tom Wells, South Valley reporter for KMTH News Radio. When news happens in Kings and Tulare counties, count on KMTH News Radio, 107.5 FM and 10 o'clock news.
I'm Silva Haropedian with KMTH News Radio. When news happens in our valley, I make certain you hear it first, right from the scene at KMTH News Radio, 107.5.
With its unibody construction and independent suspension, the Lexus RX 300 is the first luxury SUV that doesn't ride like a truck.
So what'd you think?
I'm impressed. Thanks for letting me drive it.
Thanks for letting me play with the siren, Bill.
A Fresno Lexus.
Time now for Bulldog Spotlight.
The bar has been set for the Fresno State men's tennis team, and it's pretty high. 2 years ago, they made it to the Sweet 16. Last season, they were ranked 10th in the nation. This year, they're ranked 23rd. But with success comes some stiff competition. This year, the Dogs will face seven teams in the top 25.
I think if we want to be one of those great teams, we have to continually schedule that way. And it's helped us out, you know, the last few years to play a really tough schedule. And, you know, it's helping us out again this year.
So is the Bulldogs' number one player, Peter Luchak. Considered to be the third best amateur in the world right now, Luchak is just 19 wins away from becoming Fresno State's all-time leader in victories.
If that happens, that'll be great. You know, leave here with knowing that you got some sort of record, that'll be good. Having your name in like record books and for people to come to like, try to beat you will be good.
He was the first kid that I recruited when I was hired, and he's turned out to be twice the player anybody could have hoped for. He's the nicest kid you'll ever meet, a great student, and the best leader that I've ever coached on the court.
Luchak is one of three seniors in the Bulldog lineup to go along with three freshmen. And no first-year player has had a bigger impact than Alex McKinney, who pulled out a thrilling victory Sunday against Texas.
It was such a thrill being out there, being the last match on and just having the whole crowd behind you. I mean, it was so much fun. He's having a really great freshman year. He's off to a 4-0 start in the spring, and we've moved him up all the way up to number three right now. And against Texas, a lot of people were surprised he played that high, but look, he's shown an ability to jump up to every new level quickly.
We'll visit more with the Fresno State men's tennis team right after this.
Time soon, then I think we're a team that makes the tournament and has to cause an upset to get to the Sweet 16, which we've done in the past, and we look forward to the challenge of doing that with or without David.
And there'll be plenty of challenges this season. I'm Dana Green with the Bulldog Spotlight.
It's on how to raise children, and unfortunately, none of them work. Well, there are three theories on how to guard Melvin Eli, and so far, none of them have worked.
Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Fresno State led most of the way. Dante Swanson, who averages only 10 points a game, has eight at halftime as he pulls up and hits a three. He leads Tulsa in individual scoring. Then watch the inbound play from Greg Harrington, looking for Kevin Johnson and finding him on the alley-oop. Johnson with six for the Golden Hurricane, six for Fresno State's Chris Jeffries as he takes the pass from Tito Maddox, fires from three-point range, and hits it. Also with 6 points tonight, Tito Maddox, this one of his better plays offensively. Leads up and in, gets it to go. But the big force has been Melvin Eli, who really seems to be able to do whatever he wants offensively. Johnson can't stop him, just keeps backing him in. And hooks it up and in with the right hand. Eli leading all scorers with 12 points. The stats are brought to you by Enterprise Rent-A-Car with weekend rates as low as $9.99. Call for details. Jack Bulldog shooting 50% from the field.
Right, and you can see the graphic that's pointed out. The two things, Bulldogs, remember, lead the league in threes made. 6 for 15 is good. 2 for 7, only 28%. And Tulsa is the leading three-point shooting
field goal or three-point field goal shooting team in the conference. So Bulldogs have done a good job on closing out and making shots difficult.
Fresno State's taken advantage of 10 turnovers, blocked six shots to lead this one by 10 at halftime. What do you expect in the second half from Tulsa to try and respond?
Well, I think that you're going to see them go to their spread game to see if they can get Fresno State to spread out, because that's where they're very dangerous. Another thing that they're going to have to do, Ralph, looking at the stats, halftime stats, David Shelton, no points.
Mm-hmm.
Six rebounds, you know, still a banger, still a force, still a factor in the game, but no points. They have to get Shelton involved in the offense. Only has taken two shots.
Okay, we'll see how it unfolds when we come back for the second half.
Right after this.
Fresno State against Tulsa. The Bulldogs looking to make it 16 straight wins here at Selling Arena and go 17-1 at home on the year before starting WAC tournament play next Thursday against either Nevada or Rice. And that'll be a 10 a.m. game Fresno time. And we'll have it for you live on Fox 26.
And you know, Ralph, you talked about the irony between this year and last year. Last year, Fresno State, the host, the second seed, because of the WAC wanting to sell as many tickets as possible. I mean, you're not talking about the ACC tournament. The host team is guaranteed the last game. Because the host team plays the last game, their whole bracket will play that last game. Similar to last year when Fresno State had the 8:30 game, Tulsa's moved to the early game. And what happens is, in order to give the number one team the most rest time, you play the first game. So last year, Tulsa played the noon game. This year, it's Fresno State.
Other games in the WAC today. TCU won at SMU, 84-76. Hawaii lost at El Paso, 85-77. And up in Reno, Nevada is trailing Rice, 30-19. And those two teams will turn right around and play again in the play-in game Tuesday to start the WAC tournament. And, Jack, Rice actually playing pretty well right now.
Yeah, they are. And Mike Wilkes is, you know, not only an all-conference candidate, probably be an all-conference player, but surprisingly so, because everybody knows that he's the guy you got to stop. I mean, you look at Fresno State, you don't know who you have to stop. You look at Rice, you know it's Mike Wilkes, and yet he still puts up big numbers.
Shannon Swillis will inbound to get the second half underway. Fresno State leading by 10. To improve to 24-5 overall, 13-3 in the WAC. Jeffries has it knocked away. Officials look at each other. It'll be Bulldog ball. Maddox to inbound.
Now, Jeffries and Hill's a good match. They'll be two real good players there.
18 on the shot clock. Away from Eli by Shelton, out of bounds. Still, Bulldogs will have it. Now with 15 on the shot clock.
We took a chance on that one. Could have had a foul. Slap down at the ball. Sometimes you're going to get that.
Maddox, high off the glass. Gets his own rebound on the other side of the rim. Porter for three. Can't get it to fall. Saved by Swillis. Porter. Up and in. Two Tulsa players hit the front. Porter's on the board. 42-30, Fresno State.
Shelton just took a charge on Johnson. That one right there, Tito Maddox threw it up like you do when you're in sixth grade and you're bigger than everybody else. Throw it up off the glass, get it to yourself. Moses Malone made a living doing that.
Shelton quiet offensively in the first half. Quiet, not silent, would be the actual word. Another block by Melvin Eli. Seven blocks for the Bulldogs. Porter from Maddox. Brings it up and in.
Porter from Tito Maddox.
Melvin Eli's getting he is getting away with a quick shove defensively. But really, Johnson offensively isn't the match for Eli.
Steal by Eli.
Right on cue.
Jeffries, a stutter step, turns it over, forget the dunk.
Not a night.
Charlie James.
Watch Melvin Eli get it started.
Yeah, Johnson's trying. He really hasn't had much of a chance to make that shot. He's trying to get a foul. Porter recognizes it and gets out in a hurry because he knows that Maddox is always looking up the floor, and Maddox puts it right on the money.
Shelton not only scoreless, really only took two shots in the first half, so not a part of the offense whatsoever.
A lot of that was in his due to Swillis and Eli as they're switching on him.
Rebound by Swillis off the miss by Shelton.
That time both of them played him.
Maddox through traffic. Jeffries for three. Oh.
Tito Maddox is playing like he played when he first became eligible. He's pushing the ball. He has an option to score, but he kicks the thing out to Jeffries.
So the Bulldogs open the second half with 7 unanswered points. And the lead now 17, the biggest of the game. Time again for this week in Bulldog Sports, brought to you by AT&T Wireless Services. Your Fresno State tennis teams will be in action 3 times at the Spalding G. Walken Tennis Center. Tomorrow afternoon at 1, the women's team looks to shoot down the Oregon Ducks. The men's team takes on UC Santa Barbara at 1, 1 week from today, and Illinois next Sunday at noon. For tickets, call 278-DOGS or go online at GoBulldogs.com. This week in Bulldog Sports, brought to you by AT&T Wireless Services. Boy, Chris Jeffries was wide open, had time to just set it in his sights, take his time, and fire the rainbow.
And you saw that Tito Maddox could have thrown up a little floater, but kicked it out to Jeffries because he knew a wide open three is a better opportunity. Tulsa comes out with a set play. It's that same curl play they scored on earlier, coming out of a timeout.
Hill offers his shot. Rebound by Maddox.
They are not getting very good looks.
Jeffries gets it inside. Swillis kicks it back outside. Porter looking for the bounce.
That's what happens when you stay to school for 5 years and it's senior night.
20-point Bulldog lead. Shelton with a basket at the other end. Finally, in Tulsa's second half drought, and he draws the foul.
Well, what happened, Shannon Swill picked up his third foul on a play. He tried to come out. He wanted to deny, but he was caught halfway in between. There was no chance for him to deny it. And because he was coming out somewhat out of control, Shelton had a head of steam. Shelton, we talked about, can hit the three, can also put it on the floor, takes the thing strong to the basket. And if you had told the Bulldogs that it wouldn't be till 17-12 left in the game that Shelton would get his first points, I think they would have taken it.
Converts the three-point play. 17-point Fresno State lead. Just over 17 minutes to go. Eli calling for the ball. Swillis.
Swillis thought some of that senior night stuff is going to rub off on him, too.
He swears 11 he's make for three quarters this season.
And he swears he's going to make one before the year's out.
The official was careful on that one. Looked like he had his toes on the three-point line. But it was going to be a three-pointer. That's going to be a basket anyway. Antonio Reed gets to go in. Eli touched it.
And the Bulldogs had the terrific intensity real early. Had lost it the past 2 possessions.
Similar to what happened in the first half when they built the lead up to 14 and then saw Tulsa come back to get within 5. Point Fresno State lead, under 16 and a half minutes to play. Noel Felix is in the game. He replaces Channing Swillis. Eli, a couple of pump fakes, spin move, turns, fires, in and out, put back by Felix.
Oh, Felix finally figured it out. Melvin Eli throws it up, going to come soft, go get it. That's what he did. Nice job by Noel.
Reed for three. Jeffries tips it, going to try and track it down. Does, saves it to Porter, but then he loses it.
Yeah, he tried to go before he had it. And this is the best look they've had right here.
Reed takes it inside, can't get it to fall. Jeffries rips the rebound away from Shelton and comes out of there with it.
Bulldogs don't have the intensity on the perimeter, but they're rebounding much better.
Jeffries, that's all Chris Jeffries. Rebound, take it down, stick it in the hole. He has 11.
Now he's shown a lot of different facets to his game today at both ends. Tander fires and hits. That was nice offense by Harrington. He was double teamed, kept his dribble.
Maddox backs it out. 15:05 in the game. 22 on the shot clock. Drops it into Eli. The two defenders go flying by, lays it up and in. Melvin Eli with 14.
Rapido Maddox saw it. He thought that was going to happen. He waited. He called it out. Finally got in a set. He thought it was going to happen. Melvin read him right. Took the back door.
Nice bounce pass by Harrington into Shelton.
Harrington's a terrific guard in his own right. Freshman of the year 2 years ago in the WAC.
Maddox loses it. Phoenix gets right back to him. Maddox with the left hand. That's going to be a push off on Tito Maddox. As Harrington hit the deck. And I think what gave that one away, Jack, was the arm was so high that you couldn't disguise. Got to Harrington right under the chin. Eli with 14. Felix with a putback. Dogs by 16. PH Fox 26 next Thursday morning when the Dogs Open WAC tournament play at Tulsa at 10 a.m. against either Rice or Nevada. You can catch all the action right here on the television home of the Bulldogs, KMPH Fox 26. And in case it's a little too early for you, I believe we are working on a replay of that game, 6 p.m. on K3, which is Channel 59, Cable 5.
Another set play and a timeout for Tulsa. He tried to get a timeout. That was pretty smart play by Hill. Pretty athletic play, too. Ball was going out of bounds. He tried to catch it, but official David Stevens couldn't really see it. So they've been pretty lenient with giving the player the timeout. Didn't see it there. Turnover.
14 minutes to play. 16-point Fresno State lead. Jeffries simply lost it on the way out. He went up. Hill was defending him. It slipped out of Jeffries' hand.
Yeah, Hill reached in. It either slipped out of his hands or Hill hit it off Jeffries' hand. It's a good matchup, Hill and Jeffries.
We could see it again in the WAC tournament.
It would be in the finals if we did.
Hill for three. The ball kept alive by Felix. Goes to Porter.
And Felix was behind everybody, but he just had longer arms.
Tito Maddox. Intercepted by Harrington.
And that was one he probably should have shot.
Reed. Stutter step off the glass. Puts it up and in. Boy, the little hesitation by Antonio Reed. The players kind of held up on defense, creating the opening.
John Welch talked about that in his scouting report. Reed likes that hesitation. He pulls back like he's going to stop and then keeps going.
Turnovers are even at a dozen apiece. Rebound Harrington off the miss by Porter. Fresno State's lead has been cut to 14. Harrington finds an opening, and he was collared on his way to the basket by Felix. Noel Felix reached out with the arm, grabbed Harrington on his way to the basket.
So Felix did a nice job while he was in there. Has a tough time guarding guys on a perimeter. Tends to reach, gets a lot of those reaching calls, but did a real nice job keeping balls alive. Followed up a missed shot by Eli. Starting to scratch his potential, which is pretty much unlimited.
Swillers with the steal. He has a breakaway.
Pretty good move by the guy who just came in for him.
Oh, look at the smile on his face on senior night.
Well, he and Porter.
High five with Porter.
Well, high five for Porter. Kind of a mid-range five for Swillers.
Parker, open for three hits.
Yeah, they're getting some better looks now.
Eli at the other end.
Yeah, Porter took a page out of Maddox's book there. Eli runs extremely well for a big guy.
Number 34.
You've seen Tito Maddox lay it out for him, and Eli score. Porter said, if Tito can do what I can do, threw it down, put it on the money.
Melvin Eli to the free throw line. He has 16... make that 14 points. Porter leads with 16. Jeffries has 11 for Fresno State. All
also six rebounds in the game for Melvin. Watch Swillis.
Yep, anticipated it and left. And that's about where the outside the dotted lines that we used for the Hispanic tournament. But he's going to throw it down on senior night. You're not going to miss a dunk.
Well, you practice,
never forget that one.
You practice all week for an opportunity like that.
Right.
Eli with 16 now as the pass is too long for Ingram, taken by Porter. Eli, get it.
Dribble left, right, to the right, and he got a layup. That was theory one. Play behind him and don't double.
Harrington with a rainbow three. If it's raining outside when we leave, I know why.
Yeah, you got some. It's raining in here. You got some good guards in this game. This is a. It's not surprising. Top two seeds in the league.
Well, here's Eli. Triple team that time, so he gives it up to Jeffries. Rebound to Reed. Knocked away by Jeffries. Stolen by Jeffries. A little out of control. He had Porter on the wing.
He wanted to throw it to Porter, but didn't think he could get over Ingram.
11 minutes to play. Fresno State leading by 14. Another turnover. And here's a breakaway opportunity for the other guy. The other senior, Demetrius Porter. And the assist to Willis.
Porter swears that he's going to get a breakaway and throw one down. He's gotten several breakaways. I don't think we're going to see him throw too many down. The Manby's also looking for one of those.
Oh, he's really had chances, too.
That was beyond Travis.
Coming in contact with Ingram as Ingram took the pass.
Now he came over, did a real nice job of reading it. Backdoor, came over and helped. Must have gotten him on the arm.
Timeout with 10:31 to play. Fresno State leading by 16. Demetrius Porter finishing the break.
There's big news at Subway. Two fresh-made sandwiches from the sea. The delicious Subway seafood and crab sandwich and the great-tasting tuna sandwich, both served on fresh-baked bread. To the world, it's a great new taste. To the shadow, it's a mission. Subway. Eat fresh.
Enjoy a 6-inch tuna or a seafood and crab sandwich for just $1.99 at participating Subway restaurants.
Care of all your Bulldog needs, stop by the Bulldog Shop, the official apparel store of Fresno State Athletics. The store is open Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. or shop online at GoBulldogs.com. A sellout at Shelland Arena, 10:31 left in this one. The final game of the season here. 64-48, Fresno State leading by 16.
And we talked about the three keys. Keep your focus, they certainly have. Back to the future on the defense they have, and ride the wave. Unlike the Rice game where the crowd was pretty silent, they've really gotten the crowd involved in this one.
Antonio Reed.
The Tulsa's not going to go away. They're a good shooting team. They have a lot of guys that can score. Here's where they're going to have to stop them if they want to get anything. Oh, and that's
called for the foul.
Yeah, this is
fourth foul on Maddox.
You talk about guys not having good days and guys wearing out at the end of the year. One of the referees is not having the best day today. I guess it works for them as well. Jerry certainly thinks so.
Maddox to the bench. Reed, who averages seven, dishes off to Johnston for the dunk.
It was a nice play by Porter. He got over the screen about three times. What happened, they stepped down, they just rolled. He read it well. Nice play by Reed and Johnston.
Foul away from the ball.
I guess that's theory number four, is play behind him and try to steal it from behind, but that one's not a real good idea either.
Tito Maddox on the bench with four fouls.
And that one he really didn't have to. Ingram didn't have to. Eli had come up the lane pretty far.
Five rebounds, 6 points, and six assists. Porter with the three. Gives the Bulldogs a little more breathing room.
It's a choose your poison with Melvin Eli. You're either going to come on him or you're going to go on the three-point shooter.
And a turnover at the other end as Tulsa gives it back to the Bulldogs with 9:30 to play.
Swanson went back door. He thought Reed was going to shoot it. Reed thought he had Swanson open.
Willis. Willis inside, kicks it out to Porter, gets it back, turns for the follow-away, little short.
Yeah, tough shot for him.
We've hit the 9-minute mark. 15-point Fresno State lead, 67-52 Bulldogs. Parker held by Jackson.
Jackson came out, and Parker got a first quick step on him, and Jackson reached out and touched him. You're not allowed to. To hit the dribbler. This year they've really been trying to make an emphasis on it, and that was touch foul, but he did reach out and got a hand on him.
Swanson hits a three.
And that's what could get Tulsa back into the game. Or the threes they can hit.
Jackson answering at the other end.
And that's what will keep them away from getting back into the game, is answering a three with a three.
Hands it off to Reed. Johnson turns over Eli. Tipped up by Reed. Tipped up by Ingram.
That's by Jack Ingram.
Nice play. Nice offensive board work by Tulsa. They had not had too many points off the offensive boards. Bulldogs doing a better job recently of rebounding misses by the opponent. Got away with a tough one there.
Jackson opens for three again.
I tell you, if he starts coming out, Bulldogs are going to be tough to guard off the bench as well.
Reed has it deflected that goes to Parker.
Jackson
defense gets a.
That's a tough call because Jackson's been playing a lot better defense over the last couple weeks. Especially this game has done a nice job. They tried to backdoor him before. He did a nice job in the first half denying out front. Reached in, slapped down. They're usually going to call you on that one, but he's a lot better. At the beginning of the year, they kidded Damon that he was instant offense at both ends of the floor.
17th foul on the Bulldogs, so it's free throw time for the Golden Hurricane. Parker to the line, shooting 1-1.
And only two free throws on Tulsa.
So for the final 7.5 minutes, it's free throws for the Golden Hurricane. As Mustafa Al-Sayed replaces Melvin Eli. Parker misses, but Shelton got great position, got the rebound, and then was fouled by Al-Sayed. So Shelton did it.
We seem to say every game, Shannon Swillis does an awful lot of things for the Bulldogs, but we seem to say every game there's a time that he doesn't get his body into the guy he's defending to block out and gives up an offensive rebound, and that was the case on that one. Mustafa tried to come across from the other side. Got caught coming down on him.
Shelton misses the front end of the 1-1. This time, Al-Sayed gets the rebound.
Shelton, the 84% free throw shooter.
Swillis, two-pointer in and out. Oh, great rebound by Jackson. Whoa.
So that was a set play for Shannon Swill, except it's not supposed to be a play for a jump shot. It's supposed to be a drive.
You know, he should have taken a three-pointer. He stepped just inside the line, only a couple of feet.
I'm not sure who designed this offense. I don't think it was Jerry Tarkanian.
15 on the shot clock.
Demetrius trying to get him set, see if they can get something. That's much better right there.
Now Porter. Six on the shot clock. No shot.
No.
Away from the ball. There's a foul. Johnson is called for a foul under the basket.
Ralph Al-Sayed was really working for his post position. And you always wonder when you hear a whistle and everyone looks around and wonder what's going on.
Third foul on Johnson. Three team fouls now on the Hurricane. We'll take a timeout. Damon Jackson with a couple of threes in the second half. For the Bulldogs, the lead.
Basketball on Fox 26 is brought to you by State Center Credit Union. Not too big, not too small. We're just right for you. And by Carl Jr. Without us, some guys would starve.
You first saw them on The X-Files. Now they're branching out on their own. They investigate murder, mayhem, espionage, and mysterious circumstances. It's the series premiere of The Lone Gunman, Sunday night at 9, only on KMPH, Fox 26.
For a minute, I thought you were talking about the Fresno Bee. I think they're getting a moving screen on this one.
So the Bulldogs don't even get it inbounds.
They got Mustafa. They Bulldogs came out with a different set. This is a set they used early in the year. Haven't used it much since. Worked on it today at the shoot-around. Got Mustafa on a moving screen. And what happens here is not only do you give the ball up, counts as a turnover, but because they're in the bonus, you're shooting a one-and-one. Had it happened one foul later, they'd be shooting two automatic two free throws.
Hill very close to 80% from the line this season. 6 points tonight.
Actually is 80 in the league. 32 for 40.
And he makes them both.
Don't know if Tulsa has a trap, but if they do, they may be going to it soon.
The inside threat of Melvin Eli offensively is on.
Right, you can see that their offense is a lot different. It's more this, a three-point shooting or a perimeter offense.
Stolen by Swillis. Two Tulsa players had it. Swillis came from behind and picked their pocket.
And Wisely brings it out as the Bulldogs were back in transition. He was one on four.
Four rebounds now for Swillis. She has 6 points and four assists.
Their offense is more... That didn't have enough air on it. You're trying to throw a lob from Jeffries to Jackson. But it's more penetrate and pitch or shoot threes when Melvin Eli's not in the game. The Bulldogs become like most of the other teams in the WAC at that time.
He's also fighting to try to keep it interesting.
Bulldogs are in the zone.
Swanson for three and hits it.
3 points.
That was made by Harrington.
And Tark wants a timeout because this is now a 10-point game. The right. Bulldogs had led it by 20. Now Tulsa's within 10.
Right, it's a 10-point game, but remember it was a 10-point game at half. So really, you've traded runs, but you've traded points. It's just that the momentum has swung back in Tulsa's favor. Jerry went to the amoeba zone, and Harrington was wise, penetrated, kicked it out, and they got a three. It's tough to run a zone against a real good three-point shooting team.
Bulldog fans, mark Saturday, June 2nd on your calendar for the fourth annual Big Bid Auction at Biden Field. Festivities include a silent and live auction, dinner from the Outback Steakhouse. For more information, call 244-2800.
And a return, Ralph, of the popular grab bags. People love those the first couple years, and they're back. It's a, you pay money, and you get a grab bag, and you're guaranteed to get more out of the bag than you pay.
Good. Maddox back in the game. Eli had the rebound, hits the floor, calls a timeout. Melvin Eli got hit around the right eye,
That was a play I'd say I saw when I was at USC. There was a play, Cal was playing UCLA. I happened to watch scouting the game on TV, and a guy from Cal was running out of bounds, falling down, and Jason Kidd wisely called time. That same thing Tito Maddox did right there, and Tito's been compared to Jason Kidd.
Fans come out and recognize the accomplishments of this Fresno State basketball team. The annual awards banquet on Monday night, March 12th at Tornino's. The event is hosted by the Time Out Club. For more information, call 278-2748.
I'm not sure how many tickets remain for that. Tornino's is going to do a real nice job with it, but I believe it's limited to about 500 seats.
Willis and Maddox talking over. The Bulldogs will have the ball with 5:13 left in the game, a 10-point Fresno State lead.
Bulldogs go back to the other out-of-bounds set that they use.
Yeah, they posted up Tito Maddox. 10 on the shot clock now. Jeffries takes it to the glass. Taken off of there by Kevin Johnson.
That was a great play by Johnson.
Hill knocks down Porter, offensive foul. Yeah. Demetrius Porter stood his ground and was really going to take a hit. I think he gave a little bit, but still got the benefit of the call.
He got the benefit of the call because he had his hands out. I don't know if they're going to give you that with your hands out. Here you're going to see, hands are out. But if his hands weren't out, he would have taken a knee right to the chin. So he got the charge and he deserved it.
Still just the fourth team foul against the Hurricane. They have four. Bulldogs have nine. Willis tried to get it into Melvin Eli, knocked away by Tulsa. 19 on the shot clock. Fresno State will have it.
Yeah, Reed came off Porter in the corner and got that one there. They run that play again. I think Willis may fake the pass, throw out the Porter for a three.
Maddox with 11 on the shot clock. Creates a little room for the three. Kind of lowered his shoulder. Yeah. Back off Harrington. Then hit the three.
When he's set, he can make that three. He doesn't. It's more a set shot. But when he is set and has time, he's been able to make that shot.
Kevin Johnson gets a bounce.
That's by Kevin Johnson.
Under 4 minutes to play. Swillis inside, one-on-one against Shelton, has it knocked away by Johnson, who came over to help.
Yeah, Shelton did a nice job, kind of like Carl Malone. He gets him on the way up.
And a foul on Jeffries at the other end. He got a piece of Marcus Hill, sending Hill to the line.
I think what the people don't like is that each of them are going after the ball. And it's, when the ball's thrown, it's up for grabs.
10th team foul on Fresno State, so it's two free throws for Hill.
Right, it's just that Jeffries did get some body. But this is a tough situation foul-wise. You have a three-point shooting team that can put together streaks of threes and score in bunches. And if you foul them, you're shooting two all the way out, and they're a good free throw shooting team. So this game is not out of the woods.
Hill, who averages 13 a game, has eight tonight.
I should say it's not out of the woods as far as either team is concerned. Tulsa feels they can come back. It's going to take a tough effort because they're on the road.
He'll make some votes, giving him nine. It's a nine-point game. So Fresno State is in a battle here down to the wire with 3:46 to go. We'll be right back. Ticket office during normal business hours. Don't worry. Season and single game tickets for many of your favorite Bulldog events are available online. Reserve your seat by logging on to GoBulldogs.com, the official website of Bulldog Athletics.
Or if you want, you can call Scott Weatherby. His cell phone number is... I just had to do that. Yeah.
3:46 to play. We have a ball game. 9-point lead for Fresno State. The top two teams in the Western Athletic Conference during the regular season. Maddox, sure. Jeffries fouled on the way up after getting the rebound.
Well, now we have to realize Maddox is fading. As you're fading, you have to shoot a little farther before gravity's taken. Is a problem. Jeffries did a nice job of getting an offensive rebound. Bulldogs want to see Jeffries rebound a lot more. With the wingspan he has and the jumping ability, he's out on the perimeter. He can get a running start. It's the second offensive rebound today. Fifth in the game. They'd like to see him rebound a little more, but guy does an awful lot for him.
12 points for Jeffries. That's four fouls on Kevin Johnson. He'll remain in the game with 3.5 minutes to play. Why would you take him out now?
Not much to save him for.
Reed open for three. The top of the backboard comes down to Eli.
That's allowed. It just can't go over the backboard.
Porter open for three. Swanson comes out with a rebound.
At one time, Porter was 1 for 5. He made 4 in a row. Now he's missed his last couple.
Reed. Oh, my. What English he put from under the basket, behind the backboard.
Yeah, little guy's tough. You know, John Welch, he doesn't start. John Welch is scouts culture. So that's the guy that he fears the most. He thinks he's a really quick player.
Eli. We're going to sell the side up ball. Possession arrow gives it to Tulsa.
I'm not sure about that one, Ralph, because the ball comes out of his hand.
That's
yeah,
right.
He catches it. If he goes up and comes down.
Well, we have the benefit of replay.
Well, but I mean, most people have the benefit of seeing that. Well, maybe not. If the ball's out of his hand, the ball was not in control the entire time, and that's supposed to be the call. He's passed the officials test, and I haven't.
2.5 to play. Fresno State leads by 9. Now the Bulldogs are turning up the intensity on defense. Shelton for 3, and he hits. It's a 6-point game.
That's the best look he's had all night from outside. I think the Bulldogs may look to go into Eli on this possession.
Maddox with an 8 following shoot.
A tough shot, trying to get a foul out of it.
Got to get down to play defense.
Yeah, especially in transition because they really get their threes.
Swillis with a big rebound.
Yeah, it's a big miss and a big rebound by Swillis. Maddox is holding the ball. He has to get it over at 25.
Clark wants a timeout. As Maddox comes across the midcourt line, he calls it. 1:40 to play. Down by 20. Tulsa's within 6. Wednesday night during the KMPH 10 o'clock news, head coach Jerry Tarkanian goes in-depth and inside Bulldog basketball in the Selma Auto Mall Coach's Corner exclusively on KMPH Fox 26. Brought to you in part by California Business Machines. And I should tell you, this week, we will not have a Coach's Corner with Tark. We're going to push it to the following week so we can give you a preview of the NCAA tournament. We just have one show remaining on the season. This broadcast is authorized under telecasting rights granted by Fresno State's Athletic Corporation and is intended solely for non-commercial use. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of the descriptions, accounts, pictures, or sounds of this broadcast without the express written consent of the Fresno State Athletic Corporation is what, Jack?
Expressly prohibited. And I always want to read that, Ralph, and you always say no. The longer it is, the better I like it.
Folks, it's just the opposite. I tried and tried and tried to get him to read that. And again, fans, if you want to make the trip to the Y tournament next week to the Bulldogs, call 278-4033. That's the flight to and from Tulsa. Hotel, game tickets,
ground transportation, and a meal. Buffet meal arranged by trainer Ed Ferreira prior to each game.
And entertainment provided by
him. Entertainment as well. Here's a Ferreira. In his spare time, he's the trainer.
Fans have started getting to their feet now.
This is a big possession right here. The Bulldogs can knock down a shot. Especially a 3, might put this one out of reach.
Bridges take points. Cut off from the goalkeeper. 4 on the shot clock. He has to find it.
Well, that one he had to take. Tulsa did a nice job of guarding. He had to take that one. That wasn't a bad shot. That was a, you had to take it down on shot clock.
Hill cut off by Swartz.
And they run that same play out of timeout. They're going three times.
Three. Fouled by Porter. A chance for a three-point play.
Now, this is very similar to last year's game in Tulsa. When Tulsa was way ahead, Bulldogs came back, and somehow the Bulldogs won it. Here, you can see he hasn't beaten on the first step. Fouled him on the way in.
We have a three-point game, just under a minute to play.
Now, Tulsa cannot foul and put the Bulldogs on the line. This will be to the Bulldogs' advantage if they foul, and they're not in the act because they get a new 35.
I have this as an 18-5 run by Tulsa. Away from the basketball, foul called on Sharpton.
Right, but it will give a new shot clock, and now you have 35 on the shot clock, 38 and a half on the game clock.
30-second timeout call. Bulldogs have the ball and the lead, but just 3 points. It was 20 early in the second half.
And this is what we talked about. The Bulldogs got the ball back with about a minute to go in the game. Ran a lot of time off. Off the ball foul, that was not intentional. I mean, they were not trying to foul. It was Eli and Shelton battling for position. And the foul was called. Now the Bulldogs have 35, can run it down to 3.5 seconds before Tulsa gets the ball back.
Next game, the WAC tournament open for the Bulldogs. 10 a.m. on Thursday. Against either Rice or Nevada, we'll have it live on KMPH Fox 26, and I'm told a replay at 6 p.m. on K359. That sign refers to Fresno State trying to make it 5 straight wins over this Tulsa team.
Swillis wisely goes back.
Tulsa trying to foul now. Antonio Reed.
Yeah, they were really denying the ball inbound. Swillis just, we talked about the intellect and maturity at the top of the show. Swillis sees it. He just runs back, knowing that they're trying to deny on the inside. He runs back, gets the ball inbound. That's the main thing they want. But Bulldogs have leading free throw shooter on the line.
Porter with 21 points in the game. Hits it.
Well, I'll tell you that. Tulsa will, they're happier than anyone that Demetrius Porter's graduating.
A little long on the second.
But he does make it a 4-point game.
Under 30 seconds to play. Shelton gets blocked by Eli, streaking down the floor, and a foul in the backcourt. Hill will send Tito Maddox to the line.
Shelton thought he had a good look, and to be honest, it looked like it was a good look. Eli came out. Not a real surprise that Melvin Eli blocked the shot.
His fifth of the game. Maddox to the line. This is a 1-1.
Bulldogs iced the Rice game by making their free throws down the stretch.
Tito's in double figures with 10 points.
Remember, Rice kept coming 3 for 2. They hit the 3, fouled the Bulldogs, they'd get 2. They kept going 3 for 2, whittled the lead. But you have to make your free throws or else you lose the game.
That is a nice pair of clutch free throws.
Right.
Harrington, rides on Maddox, called by Tulsa with 19.9 seconds to play. It's a 30-second timeout. Tulsa will talk it over. We're in the Bulldog
huddle. Get a press offense. Nelson's here. Travis Drew is by the ball. We're in a press offense.
two left. He's going over to press offense, knowing that Tulsa's going to press. Probably will go for the steal initially and then foul whoever gets the ball. Bulldogs in this situation try to cross their guards to get them open. If they can't, usually Eli comes up the floor. He's being guarded by Reed. Ball's on this side, so Jeffries will come up.
Maddox fouled by, if it isn't, is it Johnson or Harrington?
I was blocked out. Willis is trying to get back into the game, but the scores they like blocked out.
Harrington gets the foul against Johnson, who was also there. That was a five. The thing about a close game like this is you hardly have a time to get your seniors out for a little recognition.
Right. Right. But I know you want to walk away with the win, and they'd rather walk off the floor winners. There's a guy down the floor. I don't know if the Bulldogs know it. Just doesn't matter.
Pass is earmailed out of bounds by Swanson. He's done so many great things tonight. He has no reason to hang his head.
Now, Reed stuck down the floor behind everybody. The Bulldogs didn't see it. But by the time...
Here comes Willis coming out of the game. Shannon Willis comes out. Unfortunately, the PA announcer didn't pick up on it.
I don't think he realized that. And Jerry's doing offense-defense substitutions right now. He's doing offense-defense substitutions for free throw shooting for Demandy and rebounding and defense for Willis. At the other end, he's telling the team now they're in amoeba. They want to play the zone. Even though it may give up an open look, what he wants to do, it slows the game, and you don't get beaten off the drive. And that's what Tulsa looks like. They're trying to get the three by driving the ball like they did last time.
All the Bulldogs back to defensive. Another free throw miss by Jeffries. Willis back in. May have another chance to take a foul. Jeffries makes it a 5-point game. Score is 82-77. Harrington got up in the air. Unloaded it.
And this is what the amoeba
better here.
The amoeba guards the perimeter well. Porter lob.
Stelland Arena, the 16th win in a row here on the home floor. Fresno State, 84-77, as the players probably have an indication they could meet again. If they do, it'll be in the championship game of the WAC tournament. Shannon Willis saying thanks to the fans. Again, he is going to potentially try and get 1 year back, but has a slim chance of doing that. Band retreated to a pretty good game here. Fresno State looked like it was ready to blow it out, up by 20 early in the second half, but a great comeback by Tulsa. Got to within three at 78-75. The Fresno State hangs on and wins it by seven. The Bulldogs 24-5 overall, 13-3 in the WAC. Now the 24 wins ties the school record for most victories during a regular season. The 13 conference win also ties the school record for conference wins of 13. I believe Fresno State did that in its first game, first season under Jerry Tarkanian. We're waiting for Jerry Tarkanian to join Jack Burton.